And Dave, we're going to start off today with what's going on with Ricochet.
Well, as everyone knows, his contract is running out, and on Friday they got the WWE Speed title off of him. They had Andrade beat him. They had Andrade win in the finals of the latest tournament that they were doing, beating Tommaso Ciampa. So normally, you know, you would probably save the title match for the next week rather than do it the same night, which tells you how quick that they wanted to get the thing off of the title off of him. He's leaving, most likely. It's not like official. This morning, he was up in the air on this. He was basically up in the air. You know, had not signed the contract. WWE had been, you know, kind of, I guess, with the idea he was leaving. They did have ideas for him in case he stayed. They may write him out on TV this week. But I was told this afternoon that he did, in fact, make a decision. But what his decision is, that I don't know. But I think most people have him leaving. I think that's the safest bet of the two. I can't say that 100%. But in the words that I said to Garrett the other day on these subjects, he is going where he expects to be the happiest. So that would be wherever he expects to be the happiest. That's where he's headed.
Interesting. Well, Ospreay wants him.
A lot of people want him there.
Yeah. I mean, he'd flat out said a couple of, it was like a month ago, actually.
I thought it was only a couple of days ago. A week ago, maybe.
Yeah, it was fairly recently.
Yeah, of course he wants him there. He's one of his favorite opponents. They had incredible matches years ago. You know, it really was a lot of years ago because he's been in WWE since like 2018, like 6 years. I mean, he left the independent scene at the end of 2017, and I remember, you know, I saw him at PWG, you know, and it was funny because, you know, that was the one where, you know, a lot of people are going like, oh, he shouldn't go. And I said, he's the one that they won't screw up. And it was really interesting. I mean, he did really well in NXT for the first year. And then on the main roster, you know, he was like a lot of guys. He had to stops and starts. I know that when Paul Heyman was given the book, whatever that means, I mean, to get overruled every week. But when he was put in charge of Raw, you know, I mean, one of his things was, you know, Ricochet is one of the top baby faces as a way to attract teenagers because he thought that he could get them to, you know, with the acrobatics and everything, that it would be really good act for teenagers. And I think that went about, you know, just like a lot of the guys there, like Cedric Alexander. I mean, there was like, you know, you could, if you ever watched that period, it's like a guy would come in for about 3 weeks and Vince would just basically say, nah, and that was it. And then he had to retry, you know, I mean, Malachi Black was on that list. Buddy Matthews, not so much Buddy Matthews as a top guy, but as a guy, Ricochet, Cedric Alexander, and, you know, Vince did not approve of them, and that's what happened. I mean, Vince is gone and everything, but, I mean, you know, right now, you know, I could see a situation where, you know, on TV tomorrow where, you know, they, you know, I don't know. I mean, Braun Breaker could finish him. They might just have finished him up on Friday night. I don't know. Or maybe he's going to stay, you know. But I would say, you know, I expect him to go. The next thing is if you expect him to go, where do you expect him? I mean, you got to figure it's AEW. You know, it's an interesting one because it's a new person. AEW's got so many people, you know, it's a guy who can have a really good. Stylistically, he's a better fit in AEW. I mean, whether AEW can do anything with him, and I'm sure they'll do something with him, but you know, exactly long term when there's just so many guys on the roster and everything like that. I mean, it remains to be seen. But in WWE, I think he pretty much had a ceiling and. So it just comes from his perspective. You know what you're going to get with WWE. The one that surprised me, and this is actually the reason why I was very surprised when I heard that there was a good chance he was going to go, was, you know, his fiancée's Samantha Irvin. And, like, you know, be more happy doesn't necessarily mean, you know, getting to do better matches. He will get a chance to do better matches in AEW. There's no doubt about that. But there's more to life than just getting to do better matches. You know, I mean, especially when you got a relationship and, you know, if you're working together, traveling together, everything like that, it's a lot easier than working in two different companies, especially when you're a wrestler and there's so much travel, or in her case, a ring announcer for wrestling, when there's a lot of travel involved and different dates and things like that. You know, like if she's working Monday, you know, if you're both working Monday and some house shows, it's one thing, but when it's the idea that, you know, you may be working Wednesday and Saturday, and then she may be working, you know, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. You know, it's not the end of the world. People have made it work, but it's a lot more, it's a lot easier, you know, when you're working together. I mean, that's one of the things with a lot of couples, you know, like with Andrade. Andrade probably was going to have a better, you know, be pushed better and probably make the same money, if not more, in AEW, but, you know, when, you know, I mean, when Charlotte Flair heals up and goes back on the road, you know, they'd have a big schedule problem. And when they're in, you know, when they're both on the SmackDown roster, that they don't have that. They can train together. They can travel together. It's a lot easier. So you know, that's why it surprised me. But I guess, you know, I guess we'll see. Well, I mean, we'll know in the next couple of weeks. But a lot of people have it like it's a done deal. And I know that, like I said, he made the decision today, whatever that decision is, and, you know, the WWE will act accordingly, and then I guess people will be waiting for him in AEW if he's not coming back, or if he starts a new feud or something like that, then we'll know also.
All right, tell us about the passing of Larry Santo.
Yeah, Larry Santo was a guy who wrestled in he was a TV enhancement guy that wrestled in a lot of territories in the Southeast. He was on TBS, you know, for, you know, probably 15-year period, you know, probably like 1984 to, you know, all through that WCW Saturday Night period with the syndicated shows. He was job guy. And he used the name Larry Santo and also Larry Santana at different times. And also, you know, Alabama and, you know, Mid-South, you know, when they needed a guy, he was there. He was a reliable, good wrestler who did his job well, was well-liked, and 63 years old, and I don't know much else. He passed away last Sunday, and I saw some comments from his daughter and from Bob Cook, who you may remember was another of the job, really good working job guy, you know, who said that he would really miss him. And he trained David Young, you know, who was a TNA original wrestler from when the company first started. And, yeah, I mean, I remember good bumps and everything. Always, you know, always solid in the ring.
Hey, if you love this clip, have I got a deal for you? WrestlingObserver.com. Do you have a commute? Do you work out at the gym? Do you like listening to audio on your headphones or your earbuds or whatever the kids use today? Well, WrestlingObserver.com will give you all the audio you'll ever need in your life. Over 15,000 audio shows. Every audio show that we have ever done, dating back to 2005, is available for subscribers at WrestlingObserver.com. Every time a new show comes out, you can podcast it directly to your phone. If you have a commute, as noted, if you go to the gym, if you like to lift weights and listen to Granny review soap operas, well, WrestlingObserver.com gets you full access to all of these shows and all of these archives. You can go back and listen to TNA reviews from 2010. You can go back and listen to reviews of every WWE pay-per-view, every big story that's ever happened in wrestling. You can get access to that at WrestlingObserver.com. Plus, full access to the Wrestling Observer newsletter every week. 40,000 words of news and information in pro wrestling. Why get all your scoops off Reddit, which aren't even accurate most of the time? Go right to the source, the Wrestling Observer newsletter. You also get Observer archives dating back to 1990. So check it out today. Thousands of issues of the Wrestling Observer newsletter. Tens of thousands of hours of audio. All for $12.99 per month, or as low as $9.99 if you sign up for a year. You'll never run out of audio if you subscribe to WrestlingObserver.com. So head up there, check it out today, and I'll talk to you again after a while.